The name of Ntombi's character is Ntombi Zonke. Ntombi Zonke means all girls. And that's her motto. I'm standing in for all the girls that were abused and trafficked. I'm going to stand in for them, and I'm going to take revenge for them collectively, not just for myself.
You know, that wasn't the original title, I Am All Girls. I think it's absolutely perfect. In the South African context, with being the rape capital of the world, with our gender-based violence, with the pandemic enforcing abusers to be in the same space and not leave with the abused, I think it's absolutely perfect.
I mean, one of the things that attracted me to the project was that it had two powerful female leads, and I haven't seen enough of that kind of movie. But what was so interesting are these leads, not only were they in relationship with each other, they were also at odds with each other and represented two styles of bringing justice.
I celebrate the fact that two leads can be over 40 and still taken seriously and still have a place in great movie and storytelling. So it is drenched with a lot of the perspective of the woman.
So I wasn't the original writer of the project. A script was brought to me by a South African producer who wanted to start a South African studio and start creating a whole slate of South African films about South African issues. And so I was drawn to the challenge of trying to make an entertaining thriller without paying lip service to the issue.
I mean, never mind how they traffic underage girls overseas, when we don't have what we need to catch the guy snatching girls right off the street.
How could I bring the issue in, not pull any punches, show you what you needed to see, but at the same time, make you want to go on a journey? I needed to find real survivors and real victims, people who are still in the world, who had not escaped yet, so that I understood the world and I got a taste of the world. And I wanted that to be authentic and as real as possible. And we had based the film on a real event. Gert van Rooyen abducted six girls in the 90s.
They are abducted six girls.
Yeah, another history.
This man is a pedophile. Even his own granddaughter.
The girls were never found. And in our fantasy world of the movie, one of those girls survives, comes back, and seeks to take revenge against the entire syndicate that that trafficked her in the beginning. Having said that, the world itself, as I discovered, was so complex. And so I had to be very careful of what I chose without being disrespectful to the people that I was researching.
What I most admire about Ntombi, she's a fighter. Women don't get out of those experiences. At the same time, yes, she's a vigilante. Yes, she went rogue. You see through Jodie such a gentle, soft, and delicate side to her. I'm getting very emotional because it's still very real to me. You see that juxtaposition. And that's what we're like as human beings.
So Ntombi is a survivor. She's a trafficked survivor and managed to get out of the life and the cycle of prostitution. She qualified as a forensic analyst in the police force and joined the police force with a grander plan of bringing revenge on the people who trafficked her. And Jodie Sneeman is a dyed-in-the-wool, old-school Afrikaans cop. You know, brought up through the ranks, conservative, but feels a tremendous bond to the victims that are trafficked, to the extent that you can't separate her professional life from her personal life, and suffers along with the children that she fails to help, which happens all the time. But, and so I was thrilled. They were my first choices for the role, and they brought a lot. They have amazing chemistry with each other, which is very important for the film. A lot of silent moments that happen in the film that are very important to make you care. It's the heart of the film. So out there, there's trafficking going on and appalling things happening to children. But in the heart of the film, there are these two powerful characters in a relationship with each other, in love with each other. And I hope that, you know, allows you to relax and enjoy the film as well as, you know, be thrilled by it.
Love is so expensive. Love is enriching. Love is liberating. And love is healing. And all those dynamics are so crucial to these women as individuals because they've got such moral and emotional demons that they heal each other and they enrich each other and they can let their guards down in front of each other and they can be the light in each other's lives, enlighten each other. And that's the way I would put it out to the world.
Trafficking is defined as when someone takes possession of your passport. When someone else has possession of your travel documents, you now have officially been trafficked. And I think South African statistics are tens of thousands of people a year. So you have 14 cops trying to police that. It's just completely impossible. So from a political point of view, it's just under-policed, but it's a massive problem and it's extremely lucrative. And so if you could address trafficking, you could address a lot of issues simultaneously. And I'm sure there's the political will, because nobody wants to see children abused. But, you know, the practicalities of it, I don't think are being addressed adequately anywhere in the world.
We all came in knowing a lot less about human trafficking than to this point that we're sitting at now. And it's not about us trying to save the whole world, but it's just about empowering ourselves and our circles of influence and our communities.
You know, the best case scenario is somebody in power, someone who can make a difference, an NGO or a government official. And suddenly they think, wow, this is more serious than I thought, and actually investigates and something happens. That's the best case. But I don't mind just people knowing about it, and it's in their awareness, and maybe another day they'll encounter somebody or something or some situation and they'll help or they'll reach out. Or it'll happen to someone close to them and they'll be able to know the words to make them not feel so alone. So yeah, maybe it'll make a difference, maybe it won't. But I think it's important that we do it anyway.